The hackers who disrupted the U.S. presidential election last year had ambitions that stretched across the globe, targeting the emails of Ukrainian officers, Russian opposition figures, U.S. defense contractors and thousands of others of interest to the Kremlin, according to a previously unpublished digital hit list obtained by the Associated Press. The list provides the most detailed forensic evidence yet of the close alignment between the hackers and the Russian government, exposing an operation that went back years and tried to break into the inboxes of 4,700 Gmail users, from the Pope's representative in Kiev to the punk band Pussy Riot in Moscow. The targets were spread among 116 countries. "It's a wish list of who you'd want to target to further Russian interests," said Kerr Giles, director of the Conflict Studies Research Center in Cambridge, England, and one of five outside experts who reviewed the AP's findings. He said the data was a master list of individuals whom Russia would like to spy on, embarrass, discredit or silence. The AP findings draw on a database of 19,000 malicious links collected by cybersecurity firm SecureWorks, dozens of rogue emails, and interviews with more than 100 hacking targets. SecureWorks stumbled upon the data after a hacking group known as Fancy Bear accidentally exposed part of its phishing operation to the internet. The list revealed a direct line between the hackers and the leaks that rocked the presidential contest in its final stages, most notably the private emails of Clinton campaign chairman John Podesta. The issue of who hacked the Democrats is back in the national spotlight following the revelation Monday that a Donald Trump campaign official, George Papadopoulos, was briefed early last year that the Russians had dirt on Clinton, including thousands of emails. Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov called the notion that Russia interfered unfounded. But the list examined by AP provides powerful evidence that the Kremlin did just that. "This is the Kremlin and the general staff," said Andras Rach, a specialist in Russian security policy at Pazmany Peter Catholic University in Hungary, as he examined the data. "I have no doubts. The new evidence." SecureWorks list covers the period between March 2015 and May 2016. Most of the identified targets were in the United States, Ukraine, Russia, Georgia, and Syria. In the United States, which was Russia's Cold War rival, Fancy Bear tried to pry open at least 573 inboxes belonging to those in the top echelons of the country's diplomatic and security services, then Secretary of State John Kerry, former Secretary of State Colin Powell, then NATO Supreme Commander, U.S. Air Force Gen. Philip Breedlove, and one of his predecessors, U.S. Army Gen. Wesley Clark. The list skewed toward workers for defense contractors such as Boeing, Raytheon and Lockheed Martin or senior intelligence figures, prominent Russia watchers and, especially, Democrats. More than 130 party workers, campaign staffers and supporters of the party were targeted, including Podesta and other members of Clinton's inner circle. The AP also found a handful of Republican targets. Podesta, Powell, Breedlove and more than a dozen Democratic targets besides Podesta would soon find their private correspondence dumped to the web. The AP has determined that all had been targeted by Fancy Bear, most of them 3 to 7 months before the leaks. "They got 2 years of email," Powell recently told AP. He said that, while he couldn't know for sure who was responsible, "I always suspected some Russian connection." In Ukraine, which is fighting a grinding war against Russia-backed separatists, Fancy Bear attempted to break into at least 545 accounts, including those of President Petro Poroshenko and his son Alexei, half a dozen current and former ministers such as Interior Minister Arsen Avakov, and as many as two dozen current and former lawmakers. The list includes Serhiy Lushchenko, an opposition parliamentarian who helped uncover the off-the-books payments allegedly made to Trump campaign chairman Paul Manafort, whose indictment was unsealed Monday in Washington. In Russia, Fancy Bear focused on government opponents and dozens of journalists. Among the targets were oil tycoon turned Kremlin foe Mikhail Khodorkovsky, who spent a decade in prison and now lives in exile, and Pussy Riot's Maria Alekhina. Along with them were 100 more civil society figures, including anti-corruption campaigner Alexei Navalny and his lieutenants. "Everything on this list fits," said Vasily Gatov, a Russian media analyst who was himself among the targets. He said Russian authorities would have been particularly interested in Navalny, one of the few opposition leaders with a national following. "Many of the targets have little in common, except that they would have been crossing the Kremlin's radar," an environmental activist in the remote Russian port city of Murmansk, a small political magazine in Armenia, the Vatican's representative in Kiev, an adult education organization in Kazakhstan. "It's simply hard to see how any other country would be particularly interested in their activities," said Michael Kaufman, an expert on Russian military affairs at the Woodrow Wilson International Center in Washington. He was also on the list. "If you're not Russia," he said, "hacking these people is a colossal waste of time."